expandable organization, and how incident action plans are implemented to provide a common direction. With ICS, any agency can effectively manage incidents that reach beyond the scope of their day-to-day work. ICS Module 1, the initial callout.
So, what we are trying to do here is to refresh you that what we call ICS is not only involves one party, it involves a lot of people. A lot of people, and then how are we going to integrate to the system? So the key component we are looking at is what are the purpose of your contingency plan. So I've been doing quite a few training in Malaysia and Indonesia. The first thing I ask, have you ever seen your oil spill response manual? So most of them don't even know the response manual exists. So if you do not know your response manual exists, how are you going to respond? That's the issue here, right? Then of course, how is the response protocol being implemented? Who is supposed to call who? And then how do you activate your response? There's a lot of superintendents not realizing that. They say, oh, I just called this guy will reach everything. Right? But basically, they should be, know something about what they're supposed to do. And then, of course, the national response, we are looking at the tier series. Right? So because there's so many format of the tier response, so I would prefer two and three. So I always use the pyramid. The pyramid shows the tier response is where you have the most control, and on the top tier three you have the least control. Right?
It's not the issue.
Yeah,
the three strategy.
Yeah. So what you call, as we go along, I will be using this diagram more often. Yeah. So what you call, this is one fire incident happened in MISC ship in Bintulu with Petronas. We have fire. And they are quite skilled.
It's hacked. 2000.
Yeah.
About
5-6 years
ago. Yeah.
So, why we use this is when you have a ship fire and you have quite skilled. So, which one are you going to handle first?
Yes.
So, because this one I was involved personally.
Right.
So, I managed to get the video from YouTube looking for it. So,
July 2012, 2:30 a.m. MISC Bugalbin was engulfed in flames, which was started on board the ship at the jetty of Terminal Petronas Chemicals Methanol, Sidirian Berhard, Pula, Latin. The ship tanker was owned by MISC Berhard, and it was tasked in transporting chemicals and palm oil. The ship was registered in the port of Plum, Selangor. It was raining heavily that day. There were lightning occurring all around the area. However, he might forget something, or ignore the fact that he should bear in mind all the time. The ship was struck by the lightning whilst the ship was loading a 6-ton cargo of methanol at the terminal of Petronas Chemicals Methanol Siberian Berhard. The lightning struck the ship and caused a fire, and in doing so, caused 3 blasts to happen on the ship and caused the killing of 5 of its 29 crew members. The blasts happening in sequence after one another. person was not wearing any protection suit or equipment such as the safety glasses. He might be blind due to this incident. His life will be miserable after that worst injury that could have happened to him. There are 3 staff suffered minor injuries. However, they were treated immediately by the paramedics. What if the silo exploded? This will result more workers could be killed and injured. The distance of the incident took place is approximately 100 meters from the residential area. The safety of the residents nearby could have been endangered, which might cause injury or fatal to them if the explosion is reaching 100 meters to them, and also the fire could have destroyed their residency. This event could have affected 243 people, consists of 29 crew members, 14 patrols general.